there's another consequence that you can notice about the Earth going around in its orbit here. So I've sort of drawn a slightly different perspective than the one we've been doing in previous videos here. I sort of stuck to the four key positions here, June, September, December, and March, and I have the Earth sort of going around in a circular orbit. This is more of a top view here, and you see the Sun in the center. And so what happens as the Earth moves around, as the year goes on, as the Earth moves around, is you see different things in the sky as the night goes on. And I just want to tell you about two of them in particular here. So for instance, in December, the light of the Sun is striking this part of the Earth right here. And so this part of the Earth is going to be all lit up. And I hope you can see that just from basic geometry. So what that means then is that this other side of the Earth all the way over here is going to be dark. And sort of this region of the sky here is sort of going to be your night sky, say directly overhead. And so the question is, well, what will you see over there? And it turns out that in December, the key constellation that's up in the sky is Orion the Hunter. So I'll sort of sketch it as closely as I can here. This will be Orion. If you go out in December and look up in the sky at around midnight or so, you'll definitely see Orion. And just sort of as a feeling I have has just been looking at the sky all these years here, as I always associate Orion here as sort of a winter constellation. And I'll show you some graphics on that in just a minute, but that's just something you see because it's nice and dark over here now, and this pattern of stars, Orion, happens to be over in this direction, and so that's what we see high in the sky in December. If I go to March, which is certainly a different position of the Earth around the Sun, all the Sun's rays are hitting the Earth once again, that's going to be the lit side, and so the question is, what are we going to see in this portion of the sky in March? Well, going back to my green, sort of what we'll see then is Virgo the Virgin. And so that's sort of what the constellation art will tell us, as I'll show you here. It's sort of like a person in the sky, at least is the way the ancients liked to label it, we would see Virgo. So where Orion isn't so prominent in the sky anymore in spring, maybe when it gets dark we just barely catch a piece of it, but what would be very prominent overhead in the springtime would be Virgo. And if I continue on, there's a couple others in here. In June, it's this very odd constellation called Ophiuchus that we hardly ever hear about. And then, of course, in September over here, it would be Pisces, the fish. So you see, just based on what dark part of the sky you're going to get in a given part of the year will sort of tell you what stars and what pattern is going to be visible for you in that time of the night, time of the year, pardon me. Ophiuchus also takes a bit of a bash at our astrology because it is a very well-defined constellation that's very visible in the summer months of June, but there's no zodiac sign of Ophiuchus, like no one is an Ophiuchan, for instance, so we don't really get why astrologists sort of ignored that one, maybe because it has a funny name. But anyway, in the next video that I'll show you, I'll show you some graphics using our solar system simulator that illustrate how we do see these things in the night sky. But again, the whole issue here that I'm trying to get across is it just has to do with the positions of the Sun. The Sun's always in the center. It has to do with the positions of the Earth as it goes around the Sun and what portion of the sky is going to be nice and dark for us here. So here it's nice and dark in this situation here, so we can see Orion very clearly. Over here it's going to be dark, so we see Ophiuchus. Here it's going to be dark, so we see Virgo. And over here it's going to be dark, so we see Pisces. And that's just another consequence of the Earth going around the Sun as the year unfolds. So I'll show you some graphics in the next video.